Today we're in a spectacular location, Jasper, Alberta, and we're here for the launch of a very important car for Honda. This is the new Honda Accord, and for the last 40 years, it's been the mainstay in the mid-size sedan market here in Canada. And for the 10th generation, it's all new. The all-new Accord is built off a brand new platform that's not only lighter, stronger, and stiffer, but the new chassis uses over 29% ultra-high-strength steel, the most of any Honda product. Of course, the most obvious change is the looks. And in my opinion, it really kind of has a fastback style of look. The front is bold and it's chiseled, and the back almost reminiscent of the Cross Tour mixed with an Audi A7. If you're looking for a coupe, unfortunately that is no longer available at this time. The wheelbase of the new Accord is longer than the outgoing model, yet the entire car is actually shorter than the old Accord. It is also lower and wider. Initially, when I saw it online when it was introduced, I really wasn't a huge fan, but now in person, it kind of looks better. Maybe it's just because I'm a big fan of the previous model of its looks, and this is a huge departure from it, but it is kind of growing on me. All models get standard low beam LED headlights and tail lights. On the touring model, you get full LED lights. Wheel size range from 17 to 19 inch, and I think these 19s on this touring model really do look smart. I recently just tested the all new Camry from Toyota, and I thought the new styling for it was great. Some of you out there definitely didn't see it the same way as I saw it, but you know what, styling is subjective. Same goes for this new Accord. What I really like about this new Accord interior, it is simple, classy, and kind of traditional. Like if you compare this, let's say, to the Honda Odyssey, it has a very futuristic look. This has a beautiful finish on it. You have a wood grain interior. This has leather seats, leather wrapped steering wheel. It feels really good. And in behind the steering wheel is a 7-inch TFT display. Now what they've done is they've taken, it's kind of like a hybrid display. You have half digital, half analog for the speedometer. I wish they just would have made the entire thing digital and then you can configure it however you want. I think it would look better as well. Then you go into the center into an 8-inch display audio system, and get this, yes, you get knobs, both volume and tuning knobs. On either side, you'll have tactical buttons for functions you normally use, and then the buttons themselves for the climate control. Everything is easy to use, it's simple, it's not overthought out, and I really, really like that. If you're into connectivity, this thing is connected. First of all, you can get wireless charging on it. This one's equipped with four USBs, one in the front, one in the glove box, two in the back. And of course, those who want Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, they come standard on all Accords. Heated front and rear seats on this touring model, and a heated steering wheel, all really nice things to have. All in all, a very upscale premium look and feel. Now, one thing that I would like to see though, that it's not available on the Accord, is a 360 camera. Sure, on certain models you can get the lane watch system, you have a backup camera with different views, but I like that bird's eye view. That would be a big plus for the next Accord. With the new chassis, the A-pillar has also been moved back 10 centimeters and it's 20% more narrow, giving you better sight lines. Seating in the front and rear is now lower, lowering the center of gravity, but also giving you more leg room, especially in the back. All right, what we've all been waiting for, how does the new Accord drive? First of all, let's talk about the power plants. Three new power plants for the Accord. First one, a 1.5 liter four cylinder, direct injected VTEC engine that puts out 192 horsepower and an equal amount of torque at 192. And then you get to a brand new engine, which is a 2 liter direct injected VTEC engine. And that's basically the same engine that comes out of the Type R Civic, except it's detuned, it's got a smaller turbo, and that puts out 252 horsepower and 273 pound-feet of torque, which is the highest amount of torque on any Accord ever. And then later on this year, or beginning of 2018, there will be a new hybrid version of the Accord as well. You probably noticed that there is no more six-cylinder, but I can tell you, these things perform extremely well, being the four-cylinder turbo. On the 1.5, it's equipped with a CVT, which we have right now, or you can get a six-speed manual transmission. With the 2-liter, it comes with an all-new 10-speed automatic transmission, or you can go for a six-speed manual. One thing, normally I wouldn't say that I prefer a CVT, but one reason why I like the CVT in this 1.5 is because it has a conventional gear shifter. If you go for that 10-speed automatic in the 2-liter, you get that push button, that kind of space-age one. I'm not a big fan of that. You do get used to it, but give me a regular conventional shifter any day. When we talked about the interior, we mentioned that the seats are lower now in the front and in the back, and the whole car rides a little bit lower, and that really does make a difference in handling. Talk about handling, you have an electronic variable steering, and on the 2-liter model, you get adaptive dampening for the suspension. You have a sport button as well. You hit that sport button, and everything kind of goes red, just like the Honda theme, but it really livens this vehicle up. Even though this is a mid-size sedan, it is quite a driver's car for this segment. One thing they did talk about and has been a huge improvement on this new Accord is the quietness. Let's just listen right now. We are doing just close to 100 kilometers an hour. We're on the highway, and it is very, very quiet. Now, how do they do that? A lot of insulation. They even use things in the tires to make it quieter. But all around, it's a very, very nice environment. The new Accords also get Honda sensing, which gives you all those driver aids, and that comes standard across the board. New to the Honda sensing, you also get traffic sign recognition. And depending on what model you get a new heads-up display as well. And that doesn't just have your speed and RPM. It gives you everything for your navigation, your traffic signs, everything. It's been such a pleasure driving this new Accord in this beautiful area of the country. This car is light years better than all the previous Accords, that's for sure. Between the variable power steering, the more rigid chassis, the lower center of gravity, this thing really has a sophisticated ride. Steering wheel feels great, it's a nice size, and driving on these roads in Jasper, they really give you a sense of confidence. Speaking of Jasper, if you've never been to this area of the country, make sure you put it on your list because it is a special place. The mountains, the water, the wildlife. I know one thing, I'll be back. Make sure to check back when we get our hands on a 2-liter turbo and maybe even with a manual transmission in the future. You know, the first drive of this new 10th generation Accord really reminds me of going to a movie that you really know nothing about. But then when you leave the movie, you're so impressed with it. I didn't know what to expect with this Accord, and I can tell you, I'm extremely very, very impressed. It has a great mix of performance with those new turbo engines. You know what, I don't miss that V6 at all. The styling, well, that's subjective. It is growing on me, and that interior, I'm serious, in this class of vehicle, it is at the top. It's simple, it's basic. I think it has a very premium look and feel to it. So you put all those things together, and I don't think Honda's gonna have a problem keeping this at the top of its game for many more years to come. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up, and if you want to see more everyday reviews, hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching.